Hey guys, my name is Alex. In this quick time-lapse I'm going to try to explain to you how I modeled this sword for game assets using 3ds Max and some basic extrusion. So let's get started. I started with applying, setting up a reference image which I found on the web. I used the plane and apply an image to it and move it back a little bit and freeze it so I don't accidentally select it. Then I started to shape the blade using the plane which I converted to editable poly. Then I selected the edges and holding shift and moving it I extruded. And here I'm applying a symmetry modifier to get all the parts together. And here I'm applying a different smoothing groups, different polygons. So when I apply a turbo smooth modifier which considers the these smoothing groups, it still keeps the sharp edges. And now for the grip I used a cylinder which I converted to editable poly and did some insets and bevels and extrusions to get the shape according to the reference image. Here I applied additional lines, edges to get the more exact shape of the grip, and then just cut it so it has only four-sided polygons. Here I again applied a different smoothing groups to a different polygons. So after applying a turbo smooth modifier again, the edges stay sharp. And for the detailed part, again I just used a plane which I converted to editable poly, and holding shift and selecting edges and moving them I extruded the edges and connecting the edges together to get more detail, and then just moving around the vertices so they conform to the reference image. So this is pretty much the basic idea about creating such models, just using the planes and extruding the edges, holding shift and moving them. Here I'm rotating some edges to quickly create some more accurate shape, and then just added additional lines and move them around to get some shape to it. And here I use the FFD box to more easily move the parts around, and then just extruded the edges again and just according to the model so it looks okay. And then I just deleted the center polygons which you can see, let me see here, I just deleted them. So when I apply a symmetry modifier, these polygons don't get into the way. Here again I am applying different smoothing groups to different parts. Then I just went back and delete the some parts and welded together some vertices so I get the lowest possible count on polygons. And then just applying different smoothing groups again to different polygons, and then just at the end again applying symmetry modifier to it. And this will be it for this tutorial. This is a first time lapse I created, so let me know what you think about it, and if you want to see a time lapse how I textured and draw some shapes for these detailed versions in DDO2, NDO2 and DDO, let me know and I'll create a time-lapse for that also. So this is it, this was the final design. It took me about a half an hour and I hope you learned something new or just enjoyed this quick time-lapse. Don't forget to check out the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel. I have tutorials about using 3ds Max, ZBrush and Photoshop. subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already, comment this video, share it, like it, and till next time, bye.